mildly envious. I love the color scheme. I love the pickups.
Me too. I'm totally, and actually there's a little bit of a mod too down here.
What do we got?
These two tone knobs and this volume knob are now, this volume knob doesn't work. So this is the volume knob and this is the tone knob.
Okay.
There's just one for all pickup choices, pickup options. And the pickup options are still the same.
I see.
As a traditional Strat. But this volume knob doesn't work, and we're going to get it taken off.
Yeah, you know, I rep a company called Mad Hatter Guitar Products.
Oh, yeah.
And they have a product, Hi Ed, they have a product that's a good, he makes a product called a kill switch. And in situations like this, a suggestion or a choice would be to replace that with a kill switch, and you can go red or black.
Mm.
And it's kind of cool. You can do the bucket head. You know how bucket head has those?
Yeah.
To be honest with you, on one of my older guitars, when I had that, I found it to be useful for, like, when I was in trouble, like, or, like, if I had a malfunction or something, like what we experienced earlier.
Totally. So, totally.
You know, I found some convenience with that. So, anyhow, you know, small suggestion.
I like it.
Yeah.
I'm going to look into it.
Yeah, cool. I'll send you the link.
Please do.
By the way, about links, we mentioned Belladon. Does Belladon have a page?
So we're about 3 months old, and we have our first show, everybody. Come check it out.
Where's the show at?
It's May 13th, Saturday night, May 13th at the Black Cat Bar.
Where's the Black Cat Bar?
City Heights.
Awesome.
Come check it out. Black Cat Bar, May 13th.
Cool.
Elladon.
Let's put it in our calendars, everybody.
Going to be playing with
Heather.
Latifatron, Fist Fights with Wolves.
Great name.
It's going to be a great night. Yeah.
Fist Fights with Wolves.
Yeah. And Latifatron.
Latifatron. Man, it's the names these days, right?
Great bands.
So
great.
Cool.
Great bleepin' bands. Can I say the F word? Is that
you? I mean, it's okay.
If
no,
you feel it necessary.
Yeah.
All right. Well, maybe we'll hit you with the F word a little later.
I want you to express yourselves fully. You know, until we, you know, I do teach. You know, when I'm not doing these shows, and some of my students are yes, beautiful. But just in case some of the students are watching, who knows?
Well, then we'll just go with the bleep instead.
Continue.
Oh. You know, this is just like a... like a way to play...
Beautiful.
...some C action up and down the neck.
I dig it.
While You Were Gone.
I like that a lot.
Thank you.
Yeah, please continue if you don't mind. No? Is that just a little segue piece?
I can...
Yeah, jam a little bit, guys. Just hang out, listen to Heather.
Get it back. Yeah, I love the frickin' whammy bar, man.
Beautiful song, Heather.
Okay. Thank you.
Very heavy in the feelings there, man. Really good vibe.
Yeah, you know that song? I wrote that song after I got back from tour. I was on the road for, I don't know, 2.5 or 3 weeks last January.
Where'd you go?
Arizona and L.A. We went to Northern Arizona, Prescott, Flagstaff.
Flagstaff is cool, huh? Flagstaff. Did you play at Black Bart's?
No, we played at Hotel Monta Vista.
Okay, not familiar with.
It's cool. Check it out.
Yeah.
Hotel Monta Vista. And then we went to L.A., played in a few different places and also recorded a bunch, but that song is called While You Were Gone. It's going to be on my next record, and I wrote it from the perspective of someone's significant other that has to stay home while their musician partner is out on the road.
I see.
So the perspective is from the person at home missing their person.
I bet those are some nice lyrics there. Oh, I was trying to listen.
Oh,
I was really focused on
the vibe.
Well,
what you were playing was beautiful.
I
love the mix of, like, a singer-songwriter-y sort of folky thing and then, like, metal. Like, to me, that's where I want my solo project to go.
Here, here.
Is I want like, a singer-songwriter feel, but with, like, frickin'... there's a PGF version of the F word. But with, like, frickin' drive and tremolo and fuzz, like...
Like, drive as far as feel or,
like overdrive. Like,
oh, yeah, I gotcha.
Yeah. Like,
you
I
know,
have
by the
a...
way, that I'm kind of stoked on that modulation, that F minor to A minor.
Ooh!
Like, I'm still, like, feeling that, you know?
It's a theory thing, and it's also, like, really cool. It's just a... Because
well,
you're going from...
It's a six-chord substitution. It's the F's supposed to be major, and you made it minor. And it's a really, really neat thing if you're the melody guy. You know, you wrote it, you're feeling it, you understand the change, but as a seeker trying to jump on board, when you're on that F sharp, you know, what I have to change to, and then, you know, if you know a few scales, you can find there's a hot spot in there, and it reminds me of something that we have in common, you know, a Jeff Buckley thing, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. But anyways, great job on that song.
Thanks.
That was a great move, bold, because I'm used to hearing things that are a little bit more, well, most songwriters will just stay in a key.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, again, great modulation there.
Oh, man, there's a lot of that going on with...
Yeah? A lot of in your songs? Lots
of
modulation?
Yeah, yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah, thanks.
I would love to be way more familiar with all that. I'm gonna come see the next show, and Jason and I, and
yeah,
I'm sure Scott, you know, we'll all come out. And okay. Part of the reason of having this experience with you and the past guests is that it obligates us to socialize and to be, you know, make a family out of this.
Yeah.
You know, support you, and then... Of course, David Carano and Jeff Podeswick, and
yeah, and Ditto, you know, you guys. I'll be at your shows, and we're all just part of the same little family here, San Diego music scene, little family.
Right.
Yeah.
Cool. So I want to talk about how we met.
Oh yeah, let's do it.
So during the holidays, right around December 14th, it was a Saturday, and yeah, something like that. So bear with, right? It was the middle of December.
In middle of the day too.
Well, your game
or
was.
Morning, yeah.
So, Sheldon's Cafe is this really hit new spot out in La Mesa. It's on La Mesa Boulevard, and they have the acoustic songwriter shows, and they have three different slots throughout the day. So I went ahead, and they pay very well, and they have fantastic food. It's a great establishment. So I took the morning slot. And which, mind you, was very cold. I don't know if you guys remember around December 15th. It was like literally like a 50-degree morning. So I'm playing. Hands are freaking cold the entire gig. I'm done. And my buddy Glenn and I, we played the show. When we were done, we saw Heather walk up. You know, I already knew that Heather Nation was on the flyer. And, you know, right when we saw each other, we have recognized each other due to, you know, social media. And she was very cute and very warm, and we kind of embraced each other, gave us each other a hug, like camaraderie of musicianship. And from then on, I knew that I was going to be pretty close or very close to you, just because, like, you know, you know how you can tell when you're around warm people, and Heather's a very warm, loving person. So that was and that's why I had the courage to bother you about the Jeff Buckley tribute show.
Yeah, hell yeah.
So she, elaborate on that. Tell the audience about your idea and yeah. why you put that on.
Yeah, okay. So, Mike and I met in December, and then in January there was a tribute show to an artist named Elliot Smith. He's a folk artist from the 90s.
Love Elliot.
Yeah, me too. He's a huge inspiration of mine, and that was at the Blonde Bar, which is right off of Washington by Lucha Libre.
I'm so bummed I missed that one.
Yeah, that was in January, and so I signed up to sing a couple of Elliot Smith
Which ones did you sing?
A couple of Elliot Smith. I sang Needle in the Hay. Oh. I played and sang Needle in the Hay, Angel in the Snow, and Everything Means Nothing to Me, which is
those are deep tunes.
One of my all-time favorite songs on guitar. I haven't played it in months, so I'd have to remember it. But anyway, on that night, I know the owner of the bar, Blonde Bar, Alan, so I've been meaning to put together a tribute to Jeff Buckley, another artist from the 90s. If y'all don't know, now you know. Please, go so buy the album Grace.
Yes, Grace, and My Sweetheart the Drunk.
Sketches for My Sweetheart, yeah.
Yes. This was an idea before we met?
I've had the idea to do a Jeff Buckley tribute show for years. I just needed the right venue, and I needed the right team to be, like, behind the idea. I needed it all to be Jeff Buckley fans.
You were successful with that.
I know. I totally got so lucky. So on the night of the Elliot Smith show, which was January, I asked Alan, the owner of the bar.
This was, I'm sorry. Continue, please.
Oh, yeah, no problem. I asked Alan if he would be interested in hosting a Jeff Buckley tribute show, and he was like, everyone that works at this bar is a Jeff Buckley fanatic.
Oh, wow.
So he was like, you name the day, we're doing it. So I thought, it's kind of crazy, but let's do Valentine's Day. So
couldn't have been a cooler day.
I mean, it was a ballsy move. It was a Tuesday night. It's a tribute to Jeff Buckley. I mean, who was going to make it?
But 20 years to his death, even.
Oh.
Did you know that?
On that day?
Well, or? I did a little research on that, and I have experience quoting wrong dates and being crucified on YouTube about it. So, people out there, please be kind, okay? If you guys know what we're talking about, why don't you do your due diligence and put it in the comments for us? But I'm under the impression that Mr. Buckley passed within that week, and it was the 20-year anniversary this year. So,
wow.
I went into the gig and the rehearsal knowing that, so I built that up, you know, for me, that was one of the most important nights of my life, people.
Me too. So we had a full house band. They're all a bunch of friends of mine, a bunch of friends of yours. Mike played two or three songs on lead guitar that night, and we had like a dozen singers who all sang two or three songs. We did the whole album of Grace. We did most of the songs on Sketches for My Sweetheart the Drunk, mm-hmm. and we did a bunch of obscure tracks in the solo set, which you played acoustic for one of his obscure Morrissey covers.
Mm-hmm.
It was one of the best nights of my life. We had a huge turnout. The band played incredibly. My cellist Erdice, played with the band. It was one of the best nights of my life. I'll remember it forever.
Good. Yeah. I'm very happy to be a part of that.
I'm so glad you were too. Thanks for being there.
My pleasure.
Got amazing photos from that night.
Is that something that we can do again?
On the microphone that night, I announced that I would never do it again, and everyone was like,
"Never say
never." I got like stoned to death that night after I said that. Like everyone bum rushed me, like, "You have to do this again." So I think I'm gonna do it every Valentine's night, and
really,
I think next Valentine's is gonna be another Jeff Buckley night. But we might change artists every year.
Yeah, why not?
I'm going to do it every Valentine's.
You heard it, people.
So, you can...
What if...
Quote me on that.
What if you rotated Elliot, Jeff?
Ooh, I would love another Elliot Smith night. Because his tune... You know, he was a songwriting genius.
Did you ever listen to Heat Miser? The first band he was in?
I have heard them before, but I haven't like listened to a lot of it. I gotta listen to Heat Miser.
It's cool shit.
Yeah.
Stuff.
Thanks for reminding me. It's cool. Bleep.
Yeah, Jason, how are we looking with comments and interactions? Are people watching?
Yeah, people are watching. We're getting a little bit of comments. I think people are a little bit shy. But
don't be
nice
shy.
Voice. Like, that's
thanks.
Been, like,
aww.
Loving the voice and loving the guitar playing.
So. Well, we thank you, she thanks you.
Well, Mike has a nice voice, too, on guitar. Your singing voice on the guitar.
On his guitar, for sure.
You sing on that thing,
I thought
you
were talking about my country voice.
I actually had him sing, and he actually sang with me a couple of times, too.
Yep.
Gotta go like 30 seconds, like, whale. My dog ran away in the hymn.
That was good. That was kind of like Crambo. Ford and Norton, he did ride. Crambo, the Tom and Jerry. Jerry's uncle.
I
never saw that.
Was probably vaguely familiar with it like many years ago, but.
It's hilarious.
I haven't seen Tom and Jerry in a while.
When we're done with the show, I will throw on Crambo.
Okay.
You gotta see what Jerry's uncle looks like. He's got a mustache, a cowboy hat.
I'm into it.
When he breaks a string, he takes Tom's whisker. He's like, you know, I can't play without a guitar string. Oh. And he grabs Tom's whisker, and Tom goes, woohoo! Right. Enough of the Tom and Jerry segment. So let's move on.
Yeah.
Let me hear a chord real quick.
A chord?
Yeah, keeping it random, keeping it fun. Let's get some guitar
in
here.
Oh, my God. I love this. This. So beautiful. And then this one, too. This one is just a C, this is your standard C major 7 mm-hmm. bar chord, but you take the bar off and you just play the root.
Thank you for explaining, because this really ties into Theory Thursday.
Exactly, we're doing the theory thing, right?
I love it.
And then this is a F major 7, right?
F major 7. With a...
But you remove the bar and only play the root, so you're getting an open A and an open E string. So you're playing...
for that taking me so long.
Yeah, and I can't figure that stuff out. I almost used a bad
word. Well, when you live with a theory major for 2 years and you listen to enough Alice in Chains and Guns N' Roses without a guitar while
Alice
drinking,
and
you got your coach saying, what interval is it? Where is he? And I'm like,
without a guitar?
Well, that's how some of us get good.
Good Lord. You guys are like, I can't. No, yeah.
Yes, you can.
Thanks.
You're doing it right now.
Thank you. You're right. I can't. I should never say I can't.
Actually, never say never.
What? I should not say I can't.
We're going to write a new song called Never Say Can't.
That's really funny. Well.
Never say can't. Right? We actually, that wasn't a harmony. I jumped on the unison there.
You did.
Let me
it
try
was
to
perfect.
Hit a third. Just go, way.
Way.
Way. So flat.
There you go.
Way.
Or you can do it an octave lower. Way.
Can you help me out, Jason?
It's hard. Hard. You can't. Voice is a hard thing. The voice is a really hard instrument.
What's your nationality? I see a lot of Italian.
Oh, because I'm doing this? No, I have a ballsy mother. That's where I get all that from. That's where I get my spunk from, is my mom. No, I am mostly, like, Czechoslovakian, Polish, Russian, very pale.
Eastern European,
right on.
Russian, I'm not really sure. I've got to do that, like, 23andMe thing. What about you? What are you? Is this your natural hair color? Or very close to it?
It's a wig.
It's a bugs in a wig.
No, it's not my natural hair color. This is
but you're a brunette.
It's a washed out black. No, I'm actually a blonde.
Whoa,
like
really?
Like a dirty blonde.
Holy cow, I gotta
see
that.
The roots are right here, kind of.
They're darker than dirty blonde. That's like a little darker.
Segue from theory to hairstyle, hairstyles and products. So if we must know, I use Moroccan oil.
Ah.
I'm just kidding. I'm not kidding. I use that stuff. So,
okay, back to the music.
This is that part I was telling you about where I pause and I can't remember what to say.
I love it. Our listeners are shivering with anticipation.
Are you guys having fun? Are you shivering with anticipation? Because I am. Okay, here we are. I'm going to go ahead and just go into the next subject. Because I don't know. I felt like we were onto something, though. What were we talking about? It was so cool.
We were talking about some stuff. Oh, you know what? We were kind of getting really nerdy with theory and talking. You said play a chord, and I'm kind of obsessed with this open major thing.
Yeah. I'm going to try something real quick.
Like, you know, if you're in an open A major 7, you can close it by adding the bar, and then you can also change the voicing by just making it that major shape, that traditional.
It's great. It's subtle, but so heavy.
So heavy and so mysterious, and that's what theory, I think the purpose of having music theory is obviously communicating one musician to another with a language, but theory tells you why you feel sad or why you feel happy when you play certain things.
So happy she said that. It's like looking at a rainbow and acknowledging that's red,
yeah,
that's orange, yellow, etc. As opposed to looking at a rainbow going, that's cool. But you don't know what those 7 things are. You don't know what the red is.
And theory does both of those things. You know, like you look at a rainbow and you say, that's red. But you also look at a rainbow and you say, that's pretty.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, that's when you understand theory. So the person that told me that originally was my bassist, John Hawes. He owns Ramona Music Center up in Ramona.
Okay. Hi, John.
Hi, John. You're great. He's a total genius. He's a total genius and he knows everything about theory. You should have him on your show.
Would love to.
He's amazing.
If you're watching, please just say hi, and
John
then
I'll
friend you on Facebook if we're not friends yet, and we'll talk, buddy.
Yeah, he's amazing. He told me that years ago, 8 years ago. He said, you know, theory is the explanation of the emotion that music has.
Wow.
You would get to understand why.
I'm going
to
start saying that.
Isn't it cool?
That really translates to me. That's wonderful information.
Good. You know, because it's true. I mean, this is a C. This is a C, right? It's just a very simple chord. And then you do 2 or 3 things to it, and it gives you a new feeling. You literally, like, the serotonin in your brain changes because of the way you voice a chord. And then as soon as you make it minor, it's a whole other...
That one always gets me. Radiohead made a career out of that move, going from major to minor.
So pretty.
Right.
Anyway.
that was very enlightening, Heather. Cool. What's that?
Oh, it's like part of a Radiohead song. Like that. Fishes. That's a crazy ass song too. Like,
I'm gonna take it.
Starts in like an A major.
Oh yeah, I know that one. Yeah. I know some of my friends out there are loving this. Dusty and Tony. Watch her.
This is the, like, the verse.
Yeah.
I get eaten. Oh, shoot, I messed it up. I get eaten by the wasps. Weird fishes. Picked over by the wasps.
In fact, is that... That sounds like Tom, because I think I know Johnny's stuff. Johnny's is a little bit more arpeggio and crazy.
Yeah, you know, like, I think this is, like, the Johnny Greenwood
thing. That's the Greenwood thing?
And then that ending thing, this is a lot more Tom York, you're right.
God, good work, good moves.
Oh, thanks.
It's a great guitar play in the room, guys.
Aww. Well, over here is...
I'm a bunch of... hot air and tricks.
No, I just you're a great guitarist and you've been doing it for a long time and you have a lot of experience and...
Well, it's because I'm 75 years old. So the hair dye works.
I was just...
And I found out vitamin C takes the, well, it really fills in the wrinkles.
Oh.
So does silly putty.
It's silly.
That's what Jason uses.
Bless you.
Bless you.
You need a...
Don't you worry about a thing.
I actually have a whole bunch of napkins, just in case I blow it and spill coffee on my pedal board.
Oh yeah, good plan.
Yeah, why'd you just jinx yourself? You know it's gonna happen in the next 10 minutes.
Yeah, right. Come on.
I thought it'd
knock
be
on wood.
Take a chance, be a little bit humorous, and say, you know, just say things.
Yeah, it works. I mean, you're messing with.
How are we looking
the,
on time? We're getting close. You having fun?
I'm having so much fun. Right, I could talk about theory and the voicings on a guitar for days, you know? Like, I'm completely entranced by guitar theory. Mostly guitar theory.
Come over here and hang out a little bit and sit in with a lesson.
I would love to.
If it's convenient.
Yeah, I would love to.
Yeah,
I'm
cool.
Always in this area, so we'll just coordinate it, and I would love to.
You're welcome. Look at my schedule. So I do not leave this room.
Hell yeah,
you know
dude.
I mean?
This is awesome.
Have some people saying hi. Jake Nager says hi.
Hey, Jake.
Hi, says Jake.
Happy, says happy 4th.
Jake,
hi, Jake.
Can I just get serious with Jake real quick?
Yeah, absolutely. It's your point.
Jake, Rico's. That's all. All right, back to it.
I don't know the inside joke, but I like it. I
just
smell.
Agree. Just I, nod yes. In Rico's.
Fine.
Actually, Jake would want you to nod this way.
Fine. Well,
I'm gonna
go
this way.
I'm on Team Jake, so if he doesn't like it, I don't like it.
Oh, burn. All right, fine. The battle of Rico's ensues. Okay, the Rico's battle continues. I like it. I'm fine with it.
Should I ask?
I'll explain the Rico's. I can't even say it now. Rico's. Rico's is a Mexican restaurant in Encinitas. We'll talk about it later.
Oh,
Let's leave these people wondering.
Yeah, right?
Rico's, Rico's. All right.
So, yeah, now that we mentioned Jake, I wanted to talk about, and we mentioned Erdice, and then we also have our friend Christy Walker that's a mutual friend between us.
Oh, yeah, she's such a sweetheart. Hi,
Christy.
Christy.
Yeah, she said she was going to try to be here today.
Nice.
Yeah, and, you know, it's okay that she's not, but you're welcome any of these shows, so please
Christy,
come down.
Christy Walker Photography. She's mm-hmm. She's a great photographer.
Indeed.
Yeah.
Well, cool, right on. Like we covered everything, so let's do some plugs. Let's talk about where mm-hmm. you're playing, because you mentioned that you have a show coming up. But anything this week?
Oh my gosh, so many shows! Yeah, I play. I perform full time, so I play 15 or 16 shows a month. this week.
Is that right? That's a lot, girl.
Yeah, three or four shows every week. It's full time. I love it. So blessed. Thank you to everyone that books me. You guys rock.
Try booking me.
Yeah, book Mike.
I'm just kidding.
Book Mike. Let's see, what do I have? On Friday, I'm playing with my band, Heather Nation Band. We have a show at Hennessy's in Carlsbad, 9 to 1, 4 hours, so you can't say no, North Countyers. And on Sunday, I'm playing at Harney's Sushi from 6 to 10. That's a solo show.
When you play solo, is it just you and acoustic, or do you bring equipment?
I bring lots of gear. I bring my whole pedal board, my acoustic guitar. I use all my pedals, tremolo, delay, overdrive. I use my looper. I loop rhythms, and I play lots of solos.
You're a looper, too?
I play slide guitar a little bit on my acoustic. Yeah, I use my looper. I loop live harmonies, so I loop, like, 3 or 5 or 7-part harmonies, and it sounds like there's a choir behind me, and people are always, what the hell is going on with that girl?
Wow.
It's good, yeah.
That's
good.
Cool. That's so cool. I like doing similar things with the guitar and a string.
Yes, you sing with that thing. That's your singing voice, right there.
If you say so.
Well, I mean, everyone. If you're playing an instrument, you're singing.
Right.
It just
depends
on where you're singing.
The whole fact that instruments exist were to emulate the human voice. So technically, anybody playing anything is singing.
Well, yeah. I mean, David Gilmour is one of my absolute favorite guitarists, and that guy wails on guitar. He's singing. He's singing, and you feel it. Mm-hmm. You know.
Absolutely.
He makes that thing sing.
Ariel Levine did a really good post yesterday on his the Pink Floyd solo, and he was playing a Strat. And Ariel, you're doing some great bends. Good stuff, buddy.
You should have him on this show. He's a great guitarist.
Totally. I would love to have you on the show, Ariel.
And Erdice, too. You got to have Erdice on this show.
We got to have Erdice on this show. The cello would sound killer in this room.
And he'll talk your ear off about theory. He knows... Erdice is a genius. He knows everything. He's my guitar teacher as well. So everything, all this shredding that I have newfound information and techniques for, it's all from that guy. So.
I love it. Yes, he is quite the metal influence.
Mm-hmm.
And I was going to ask you, like, on your pedal board, what do you normally use for your loopers? Like, what loopers?
For the looper, I have an RC20 XL that I use for my loops, which is like a little caveman era. But it works. And for the guitar, for my voice, I have a delay and reverb effect pedal
with
the looper.
Oh, cool.
And then when I loop the guitar, I really have like just only a light delay. And then when I solo over it, I use my tremolo and my overdrive and the volume boost. I use one overdrive pedal as a volume boost, and then I use the other overdrive pedal as a drive and gain for my acoustic.
Very curious to see that. I like that one man.
You should come
band.
Check it out. Well,
definitely come out. Is it, you said this Sunday at Harney? Or?
At Harney's in Oceanside.
Oh, Oceanside.
But I play a lot down here. I just played in Crown Point. I just played in La Mesa. I'll let you know.
Where in La Mesa do you play?
Well, the one that's plugged, the unplugged shows are at Sheldon's. That's just me and a guitar. But the one that's plugged in is Boulevard Noodles.
Okay.
So I'll be there again next month.
Familiar with that place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's plugged in. I'll let you know. If we're not already friends on Facebook.
We did. I just did it right.
Okay, good.
Like a couple days before, I want to get a little bit familiar with your work and stuff.
Cool.
Very, very, very pleased.
Oh,
very,
thanks.
Very, very good.
Oh, thanks. I just try to surround myself with really badass musicians who know everything and really intimidate me, and then I try to play at the level. I really just keep hustling.
I do the same thing. Yeah.
It's important.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, every time I'm in the room with, like, David Carano, Jake, or, like, Harley, I've done a lot of work with Harley the most, but for some reason I have so much respect for my friends in that capacity, I tend to freeze up a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
I'm, like, I'm kind of known for doing exotic scales and stuff, but I'm like... And then, like, Jake will be like, loosen up, man, cut loose. And I'm like... Okay. And then it's like, for some reason, though... Because, you know, you guys are gigging all the time. I look up to that. I do. Trapped in this little studio with Jason every day. We're like, we want to go outside and play.
As you should.
Did I just have a weird voice come out of
me? Yeah. That was like, I don't even know what that was.
Yeah, you always have a weird voice. Most of the time, yeah, for sure.
Love it.
I'm going to try not to let that side of me come out too much. Well, I also want to mention Boogie Magazine. You know, in the intro, Boogie Magazine is sponsoring Theory Thursday. I also write a column in that magazine. Eli, what's up, buddy? They're very nice to me, and it's a great read. I'm always writing columns about theory, and I have a new column coming out about why you should run in stereo. So you know me. I'll put out the link. Please read it. And this is Heather Nation. I'm Mike Ruggiero. Jason Thomas as the co-host, and we have a sit-in today from Mr. Scott Cliff. Thanks for sitting in, Scott. So I'm going to end our show with a jam. We don't know what we're going to play yet, but you're going to just sort of start it. And Jason,
I think you're
going to
like this one.
Yeah, well, I'm going to... do you want me to dare to just throw the... I picked like a tribal beat.
Well, do it. Yeah, do it. Do it.
Want it faster?
No, it's good.
We will see you next week. we're done. Good?
Yeah.
Great show. Yeah.